Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning. Welcome to my morning voice again. Anyway, guys, how are y'all doing? I'm glad to have you back. We're here in the Nether. Good morning. Hello. We're on a trip today. I thought we would come in here and, you know, we have a lot of new viewers. We have a lot of new audience members here. And I haven't officially greeted everybody new. And I would be remiss if I did not do that. So to all of you that are new, have subscribed in the last few weeks, welcome. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the channel. Thank you so much for coming to hang out. And I'm glad you're digging the show so far. This is our slime and witch farm train station. A lot of you guys, I'm sure, already remember this build. This is our Tim Burton build. And this is the MC Noodler statue of a slime cube. We need to pick up some resources for the build that we're going to do today. It's not an artistic build. Today is a mechanical enhancement that we're going to do. Anyway, but this here, we'll grab some materials here though. This is our slime and witch farm. I've taken a bunch of these materials, resources, over to Camelot County, but just so you guys can see, like, I mean, this stupid farm is nuts. I mean, spider eyes, look at that. I mean, oh, this is crazy. Water bottles. This is going to come in extremely handy once we build our potion making room. Gunpowder and sugar are the same. Yeah, let's actually make torches, redstone torches out of these, and we'll be in good shape. I guess that's all we need. We need some slime balls for sure. And I've come in here, of course, made up some slime blocks. I'll meet you back at Camelot County in just 1 second. Check it out. This is we're actually using our little roof entryway in an official capacity. We need a lot of obsidian too, boy. It's a lot. Okay, well, I guess we'll grab a bunch there. Okay, so we're off to the Nether. We're gonna work in the Nether today. And what is the plan? What is the plan? Again, for people that haven't seen this, this might be interesting. We're going up to our gold house. We call it the gold house. It's our gold farm. Jump. There we go. I don't know what's happening there. All right, so this is the gold house, but this is just a housing area for a nice decorative build that we're about to mess up. It's so clean. It's so clean looking. It has such clean lines. Big chimney coming out of there. But yes, we can't. I have to put a bunch of stuff up here in the ceiling because, as I mentioned a few episodes ago, I have a problem now. I put in the second layer of the donut up there and it just lags everything down, like it bogs the whole game down when I stand up there for about 5 or 10 minutes. And the reason for that is because like everything Grimo builds, it's an inferior design. I watched Snow Crash's videos and everything, but I had to do some tweaks. There are so many XP orbs that sit down here. They actually lag the game like really, really bad, to the point that the farm stops working because everything lags out, and the XP all sits right here on this platform right here, and it's just horrible. And I have to climb down here and collect the XP myself, and that takes a long time because it's of course lagging, so it doesn't work really well. So today we are going to implement the slime block bouncy redstone tower thing that will actually bounce the XP all the way up to us. Now, I have to do, obviously Snow Crash designed his in a way that if you were going to build this yourself, you should build it how Snow Crash builds his, because it works really well, and it's just, it would be done. You'd be done and it would be, you'd be all finished. It's a little more intensive than this one, but it's not really any different. It just has 4 drop areas, and so you have some more platforming out to do with the redstone. But because mine is sort of custom made, I had to sort of use his design as inspiration and then sort of do my own sort of build to get the slime blocks to work and everything. By the time I was done yesterday in creative mode, making sure everything worked, it seemed to be pretty awesome. This is our initial platform here, where the lowest point of redstone is right here, and I had to cut into the roof 1 notch. This is our fading clock thing, which we've done exactly the same thing. We did it in the mesa for our trapdoor, our piston door. We did that a signal fader, so that it's sort of like a clock, right? So when a signal comes through here, this will run and then it'll slowly degrade each time, because each time it goes around, the comparators will subtract one from the signal as it goes around. So we will have this and this, and we'll eventually put a torch right here, and this is the torch that powers the whole thing. So we'll leave the torch out for now, because we don't need the clock to run while we're working on this. So now here we have, this is a repeater delay, and I believe this is going to go into a block with a torch on it like that. Now these all need to be set at 4. This is again directly from Snow Crash's design. I'll put a link to his tutorial in the description, and probably one up here in the little info box as well, if I remember. Let's put some redstone. But yeah, so even though, you know, I build other people's designs because, hey, that's the nature of innovation, right? I mean, why try to work on something that if you've got someone has already done it perfectly, you can learn how it works by building theirs, and then perhaps you can use those concepts later to make something different, whatever. So we learned about the clock, the fading clock here, and this is a repeater delay. So this torch signal, so the torch will go here. You can actually see how it's going to work. So there, that starts the signal, which sends a signal over here that briefly turns the torch off, and then it goes back on. And then when the signal degrades all the way there, you see it fired again, and it's going to send it there. So the clock is here to run. This is actually the signal that triggers everything. And actually, we're going to run a signal out of here as well. We're going to take a redstone signal out of here and do two different things. All right, so this right here, that is where our slime blocks go, which means our hoppers go right underneath. But we also need to put in, I believe here, we need to put in obsidian. And then, of course, up here, that's going to be more obsidian. And then there's going to be obsidian on top of those up there. Oh, I can just reach those. There we go. All right. So what I'm going to do is basically rebuild this little platform. Like these three hoppers here go into this side, and these three hoppers here go into this side. We're going to rebuild those and take them and take two towers here going straight up. All right, so this one goes here like that. This one's gonna go in here like that. Okay, and of course we can take this out a little ways, because now this is where our ice thingy is going to go. Ice thingy, it's a technical term. Sticky pistons go here, and ice goes on top of it. So when these are powered, they'll be extended, which will block this in. So we could go over here now and maybe do our double piston extender out the back over here. Perfect, right there. And then I believe our observer block, what did I do with that? Yep. Yeah, so I literally have never, first time I'm gonna use the observer block. Oh, I put them backwards. We want his observer face to be, so that's kind of weird. So the observer face faces away from you when you place it? Yeah, because that's the back end. Okay, so that fired. That's just, I guess every time you place one, it observes a change and it fires off a tick. So what you saw was this powered this piston, which fires it. There, so they grabbed him back. There, and a block here, and a block there. So we need some repeaters in here. That repeater goes in there like that, and this repeater faces the other direction. So what's happening here is, do we have a, yeah, let's do this real quick. Jump up one. So we have redstone and redstone there. Okay, again, so it just, this literally, when I dropped redstone on this block, the observer went, oh, something changed in front of me. Let me spit out a redstone signal. Yeah, the signal is so fast that it's like a, I forgot what that's called, but it's a one tick pulse, I guess, and that causes the piston to drop its blocks. So it can reliably do that. You know that sort of pulse will always drop the blocks, and then if you send it again, it'll pulse out and grab them and bring them back. Yeah, so this one stays full on one tick, and this repeater gets bumped down to three ticks so that it happens after. And we're gonna run a redstone signal in here from our clock down there. So let's watch it. There you go, that's powered. See it, double extended there. And now when the signal goes off, everything comes back. All right, so let's continue this on here and see where the signal is gonna take us down over there. We're gonna link it up. down yonder through this redstone here, all the way up here. We're going to put a torch right here. And then we're going to take this up here. So we need to power these guys from this torch here. And we'll do that with, let me jump up here and see if we can throw in our repeaters. There we go. And how about some redstone dust? There we go. All right. So now there they are. So they're fully extended. And of course, they'll turn off when this clock sends it a signal. These will turn off first because, of course, the signal runs up here, hits this torch, turns those off. They'll retract. The signal then is going through the rest of our double piston extender over there, which will launch our slime box forward. So they will send the XP down this little ice path here. I'm going to talk a little bit about why one of the reasons I think redstone is such a cool thing for both kids and adults, anybody of any age to do, because, you know, I would see things like mechanical things or cars and, you know, or just things. And I, you know, even this, like, as an example, I'd see this redstone device here and somebody, you know, I watched Snow Crash do it and I'd just be like, oh man, it's, for some reason there's a block in my head that's like telling me somehow that even though thousands of other people do this technical thing, I can't do that. Like, it just won't work for me. Things will just break or they won't function right, or there's no way I would be able to follow a design or learn how something works. And in reality, you totally can. Anybody can. This game, I think, allows you to do tests and experimentation very easily, and you can see, like, oh man, things do just work. You know, when somebody explains something to you and it does work, you can build it too, and you can make it, and it does work, just like they say it does. Sometimes you run into problems and you have to troubleshoot, but that's part of the learning process. That is the cool part of, that's when you're actually learning the thing, you know, instead of just copying designs, is when you have to troubleshoot the thing that you built. When I first found this mindset, or got out of the original mindset that I grew up with, which was like, I can never do anything, you know, technical, it just won't work, is when I started working in the movie industry. And my first day on the job, which I kind of talked about before, was like, you know, oh, here, you're gonna sit down and you're gonna build this giant thing and use all these new tools that you've never used. And I was just like, whoa, I don't know what to do. But then you just do it. And I was like, oh, and it was like, after about a week on that job, I realized, oh, things like building a house and building cars and everything, they are not, technically, rocket science is not rocket science. It is rocket science, but what I mean is everything breaks down into smaller procedures, smaller techniques, and each of those techniques breaks down into a smaller set of steps. And everything is just a step. You do one step, and then you do another step. You do another step, and the next one, and the next one. And all of a sudden, you have this complex thing, and it's all just because you went step by step by step. As a concept, I really enjoy it. I like knowing now and understanding that, yes, everything is doable, you know, and you can really do anything that you want to do if you put your mind to it. That's not to say it's easy. It's never to say that things are easy. Minecraft is easy. I mean, we build things like this that are technically difficult. This isn't even technically difficult. This is pretty easy. Compared, relatively speaking, but you know, there are things that are, you know, but things outside of a video game that are much more difficult to do, but they are doable. And I think that's to me that's a super positive thing to try to keep in mind, is that everything is doable. You can do things, even big, crazy, hard to do things can be done. You just have to keep the faith and put one foot in front of the other and take a step. And take the next step. All right, so we've got our first layer here. This is our first stack where we're gonna put up another layer of slime blocks. Okay, so this is our first relay layer. What goes up here is this needs to be next to a piston. Another piston facing this way, there we go. This, on this block row here, this is where the XP will be bouncing up from the base level. And of course, we're putting in our next row of slime blocks. They are going one block back from those. And of course, the reason for that is, yeah, they're one block back, right? So when the signal comes up this torch tower like this, the torch will run through here, will fire all these at once. These are on zero ticks, these repeaters here. And this one's on three on a delay. So what happens is the signal goes through here. These are hot. goes through here, runs through here. This one fires. Slime blocks will punch forward, but they'll carry this piston with them. And when this piston moves over to this repeater, then it will fire upwards. So the idea is that the piston, the slime blocks move this way and then up. So I'm going to put in this entire tower, I guess, all the way up and build all of the platforms. And maybe we'll just do that in the montage and get it over with, because it's just going to be tedious and I got to get it done. And there's 8 platforms that have to go all the way up. So I need to go get some more glass and finish that out, and I'll take care of that, and we'll do that in a montage. If it works yet, we're gonna try it out. So put this in, starts everything working. Let's take a look and just see, make sure all of our things are starting to work out okay. So here we've got a problem. Why is it sticking there? So it needs to fire forward and come back. I think the problem is that this is maybe this is making the signal too quick. See? Yeah, so those slime blocks need to retract. Yeah, this is not right. What if we just... This might be bad. This might be bad news here, but we're gonna try this out. I'm gonna take this out. Wow, I didn't mean to take all that out. Let's just try this out here. Troubleshooting already. Okay, this is the way it goes, right? All right, so now let's see. Everything looks correct here. The slimes are back there. Okay, so now the next time it fires, let's see it go. Okay, so that works fine. So I didn't glass this in. These bridges here, they're not glassed in yet. They're just open. So I don't know what to expect here. Oh, really? Come on, I just want to go up there. All right, we'll do it that way, I guess. I'm so coordinated. Crime Mo is so coordinated. So let's see if our thing there, you can see. So our machine keeps firing all the time because it's on that clock. And the signal will let things fire one after the other. So what, there's one that's stuck down there. You see that? It's stuck in the out position. So something is wrong on that one. How do I even get to that? All right, more troubleshooting already. It's that one right there. Okay, so this, why is that stuck in the open position? It might be just simply because, why isn't that pulling back? Oh, this is out of sequence. Oh, that's it. See, I missed that timing right there. That's why that was firing before this one was firing out. Now it's gonna grab it. There we go. Now it should all be working fine. See, you missed a little thing like that. Kills your whole rocket plan. Everything is rocket science, see? Okay, let's see. Perfect. shall we do an experiment here? I did want to say also, guys, thank you so much for all of your comments and everything on last episode. The roof, the pool roof to the shorting system. Thank you guys so much. I'm glad you guys enjoyed it. All right, here we go. That's nice and loud. All right, send me the pork. I have no idea. It's so hard when you do this in single player and you can't see what's going on down there. I don't see any XP yet. No, I see zombie pigmen, like, stuck. There's XP. There's a bunch of XP. Where's it going? You know what I didn't do? I didn't put glass across all every layer of obsidian like I should have, so I need to go up there. You never know you're making a mistake, right? I mean, that's why it's a mistake. You never know you're making it. You always feel like you got everything taken care of, everything's done, everything's working, but you never know when you make the mistake. All right, so the problem with this is, well, we saw there was a bunch of XP over there. So evidently what's happening is that somehow I've got the rhythm off, which means I need to check each one of these layers going up. Okay, so according to my creative mode diagrams, I missed a repeater on this one here. But now, what is the problem here? Okay, so supposedly this is supposed to be the timing for the next one up there. Wow. So it would be nice to go down there and watch, but we have to check it out from here. When this is working correctly, we'll see the XP. Okay. Whoa. Oh, look at that. Is there more? Come on, that can't be it. Okay, all right. Was that really the problem? I just missed that one repeater. Oh, is that not gorgeous? Is that not just the coolest? Look at this. Let's repair our pick while we're here. But yeah, I think this is awesome and finally successful, I think. Oh, that's what I'm talking about right there. Send it over. Send it over. Okay, guys, this is I declare this to be a success. And it didn't take too much. I didn't make too many mistakes, just a couple, but you know, I make them. And the thing is, I guess I don't have to go, well, some of that stuff is floating, and I'm not sure if I put glass, if I glass it all the way up, or blocks, it doesn't have to be blocks, I mean, it doesn't have to be glass, but if I walled in this chute right here, all the way up, maybe that would help with some of the extra XP. Look at all that XP right there. Oh, yes. That's what we're talking about. So now it shouldn't get laggy now. This machine should just run itself. The gold farm should let me be AFK here for a little while. Look at that, we've already gone up three levels. I mean, I haven't even barely been talking, four levels. This is a stack of XP coming. So I don't know, just to be safe, I might put walls in there, wall in this chute. But yeah, I think, look at that, 46 levels already. Oh man, this is so awesome. So awesome. I'm so happy. And it was, you know, just something we made up. We took someone else's design and sort of jerry-rigged our own version of it. And it seems to work really, really great. And I'll be coming here a lot more to repair my tools than I will be going to the Ender farm, the Ender. Because I've got stacks of Ender pearls, you know. We have way more than those. But this, I think, is very cool. I don't have to do anything. I can sit here in AFK for 5 minutes. Thank you guys for hanging out. I had a great time. I'm glad I built something. I hope this episode inspires you to build something new or take new risks in life, whatever, you know. Just do something cool. Everything is doable. Just remember that. Everything is doable. All right, guys. Take care. It's Cryo Mo. Hope you have a great couple of days. I'll see you in the next episode. See ya.